Let's check out the latest plugin by Waves Audio. Before inserting the plugin here and letting you know how this plugin works, it uses a new technology called ARA, which stands for access, Audio Random Access, right? It's a technology that allows the plugins to intercommunicate better with DAWs, especially when it comes to structures, and to seamlessly create a good synchronization between the plugin and the DAW, specifically talking about structures. In this case, we're going to synchronize vocals, right? So what's inside the plugin, the structure of the vocals inside the plugin, needs to be very well aligned with what's happening on the DAW, because it will it will align everything, right? So it will move the audios like this inside the plugin, and it needs to do that also outside the plugin. So that's I was reading a bit about the IRA, the Audio Random Access technology that this plugin needs. Most DAWs are compatible with this technology. Not all of them, I think. Ableton doesn't have it, but Pro Tools, Cubase, Reaper, Cakewalk, Studio One as well, Nuendo, all of those plugins support that. So for instance, let me know, let me explain quickly here on Reaper how you can activate this ARA type of plugins, right? But anyway, the plugin also will open up as a VST3. So for instance, here under preferences on Reaper, and you can go to the Waves Audio's website where they have a tutorial for each one of the different DAWs to put this, to set it up, right? So here in Reaper, if you go here to the preferences, right, the general preferences of Reaper, down here to the plugins section here, we have ARA, right? This ARA needs to be enabled here, right? These two squares need to be like that. And you click apply, okay. And now Reaper can load this plugin or your DAW of choice, right? So let me show you these tracks. I have three lead tracks for vocals and three backing vocals, right? So they are completely unaligned. I did it intentionally. So take a listen.
Well, it never takes long till they leave her, stinging from the loneliest touch. Will she ever break free or just surrender again? You know it happened.
It's a mess, right? It's a mess in terms of the alignment of the tracks, right? So it's very simple what we need to do here. We can insert the plugin here on any one of the tracks, but I like to go with the main track. For instance, the main lead track, it's here, and we can insert the plugin here just as a normal plugin here on Reaper, Sync VX, right? It's gonna be a VST3. Here it is. It lets you know some instructions to set the tracks, because for instance, if we have lead vocal tracks and backing vocals, maybe the backing vocals doesn't need to be aligned when it comes to pitch with the lead vocal. So we need to set tracks as reference and tracks that are going to synchronize to that reference, to the main one. Can be lead vocals, can be backing vocals, supporting vocals, stuff like that. So I already inserted the plugin here on the main lead vocal track, and I need to set this as reference, right? This is a reference, so reference one. You have the option up to, let's say, how many references? Four references and four tracks that can be synchronized to that reference. So yeah, that's quite a lot of options, I think. So for instance, I'm gonna set this as reference one. What I need to do now is to start adding the Sync VX plugin to the other tracks. It's very simple, and they are going to start appearing here just in one window. You're not gonna have a ton of windows of the plugin. So let's add it, for instance, here, Sync VX, right? And it's here. It's actually super lightweight, the plugin, because you're adding one instance on each one of these tracks, but the main window, it's this one, right? And it's very, very lightweight. I was surprised as to how lightweight the plugin, how CPU friendly the plugin is, like 0.01%, 0.02%. It's aligning automatically, as you can see here. This bar that you can see, it's aligning everything automatically. You don't need to do anything. Very impressive. So we are adding a third track, and it's going to align it. You can cancel the process, but we'll align it automatically. Then let's add, for instance, the backing vocals, right? So we do the same. We add the plugin here, and it added this background vocal one. Let's add background vocal two. And it's very, very quick to work. Of course, the longer the tracks, right? But it's relatively quick to finish the job. That it was meant to be used for. So we have all of the tracks. What I like to do here is, since the main lead track is this one, it's already in reference one, and these other two tracks need to be, like, for instance, synchronized, right? So they are in purple, right? So you can see, like, the tracks that are synchronized based on the color or the number. But for instance, this background vocal one, I'm gonna set it as reference two, right? And these two other backing vocal tracks are going to be in orange, right? So yeah, that's pretty much it. Here is processing already the audio. By the way, you can also, you have a couple of controls here for the percentage of alignment, right? Time-wise and also pitch-wise. So this one is 100%, the alignment, right? 100% it's good, but you can move it a bit, unsynchronize a bit with this knob, but let's leave it here 100%. And also you can, all of the tracks can be aligned in pitch with the pitch control that we can turn on here, right? So let's hear now the alignment, how it ended.
Well, it never takes long till they leave her.
Right now it's synchronizing, right? Let's wait for the synchronization, synchronizing everything. It's quick to work with. Let's wait a bit. Okay, so
well, it never takes long till they leave her.
Still not there yet.
Stinging from the loneliest touch. Will she ever break free or just...
It's analyzing everything. It's almost finishing. Yeah, it's done. Right? So let's hear it.
Well, it never takes long till they leave her.
Everything perfectly synchronized.
Stinging from the loneliest touch.
It's not only moving like... it's not only moving the beginning of the track or some, the beginning of the recordings here. It's like moving every small nuance of the recording track. It's moving it, extending it or the opposite, right?
Well, it never takes long till they leave her.
Without altering anything.
Stinging from the loneliest touch. Will she ever break free or just surrender again, you know?
Right, and for instance, here we can visually see the movement before, right? Before and after. So you can see how everything moved with the plugin. And it's automatically, I don't need to do anything, it's synchronizing automatically.
Well, it never takes long till they leave her, stinging from the loneliest touch. Will she ever break free or just surrender?
Everything perfectly synchronized. Very, very cool. And let's check out the pitch, because, for instance, you can hear the backing vocals here. You can solo also, right? Or mute. Let's solo the backing vocals.
Never takes long till they leave her.
We can like synchronize the pitch of these backing vocals with to the main vocal tracks.
Never takes long till they leave her.
Wow, so it's everything is now in the same pitch. Let's hear it.
Well, it never takes long till they leave her, stinging from the loneliest touch. Will she ever break free or just surrender?
That's why it's important to leave the pitch sometimes out of the equation, because of course backing vocals are harmonizing and everything, thirds, fifths, octaves.
Well, it never takes long till they leave her, stinging from the loneliest touch. Will she ever break free or just surrender again? You know it happened.
All right, and as you can see here, let's see, everything was moved, right? You have here this little icon. So not only that happened inside the plugin, also it happened here.
Well, it never takes long till they leave her, stinging from the loneliest touch.
Well, I mean, it didn't happen like this, like moved. I was wrong about that. It doesn't need to do that outside the plugin, but it's still connected with the ARA technology. And with, one instance of the plugin here on the main vocal track.
Well, it never takes long till they leave her.
And for instance, if I open the plugin here, it's whatever you open up the plugin, you have all of the tracks that are working together, right? So yeah, pretty cool. And just to show you quickly, let's check out the CPU performance, right? As you can see here, super lagged weight, 0.12%, 0.01, 0.13, 0.13, 0.07, 8.08, 0.11. So it's very, very lagged weight on the CPU, right? Very, very cool. 35% off introductory price, right? I understand this is not an affordable price, $129, but the things that this plugin can do for you, saving a lot of time. So I think it has a lot of value, this plugin by Waves Audio.